Namaste. Welcome to the next video of Machine Learning Practice course. In this video, we'll study dimensionality reduction. So far, we looked at wrapper-based and filter-based feature selection methods. The objective of the feature selection method is to reduce the number of features so that it becomes more efficient to train the model. Another way to reduce the number of features is through unsupervised dimensionality reduction techniques. A scalar.decompose module has a number of APIs for this task. We'll focus on how to perform feature reduction with a specific technique called principal component analysis. And we'll focus on how to perform PCA in sklearn. So let's have a short tour of principal component analysis. Principal component analysis will be covered in greater detail from theoretical perspective in later weeks of machine learning techniques course. So principal component analysis is a linear dimensionality reduction technique. It uses singular value decomposition or SVD to project a feature matrix or data to a lower dimensional space. The first principal component is in the direction of maximum variance in the data. In other words, the first principal component captures bulk of the variance in the data. The subsequent principal components are orthogonal to the first principal component and they gradually capture lesser and lesser variance in the data. We select first k principal component such that we are able to capture the desired variance in the data. Sklearn.decomposition.pca API is used for performing principal component analysis based dimensionality reduction. Let's illustrate PCA through an example. So on your screen, you see training data with two features, x1 and x2, and the blue points over here are the training samples in the feature space bounded by x1 and x2. Now we are trying to evaluate three vectors for being the first principal component. These three vectors are c1, c2, and c3. So what we do is we try to capture the variance covered by these three vectors. For doing that, what we do is first we project the original data points on these vectors and we find out what is the variance captured by each of the vector. So Z is the projection of the original data points to the principal to the candidate principal component vectors. So the red points over here is the projection of the data points on the first principal component. The grayish points are projection of the original data points on the third principal component, which is in gray. And then we have the bluish kind of projection, which is projection of the original data point on the vector C2. So you can easily see that the maximum variance or the bulk of the variance is captured by the vector C1. So out of these three candidate principal components, the vector C1 captures most of the variance in the data. And hence, we make C1 as our first principal component. Now, even though C3 captures the lesser variance than C1 but better than C2, we do not select C3 as the second principal component because the subsequent principal components have to be orthogonal to the first principal component. Hence, we select C2 as our second principal component because among different vectors that are orthogonal to C1, C2 captures most of the variance in the data. Hence, C2 becomes our second principal component. And when we select these orthogonal vectors as principal components, we make sure that these new feature vectors that are derived from the original feature vectors are independent of each other. So there is no relationship between these new features. And that kind of thing helps us in reducing the number of features. Now what we do is, if we want to reduce the number of features from 2 to 1, then obviously the first principal component is our best bet, because the first principal component covers the maximum variance in the data. And what you see here in red is the projection of the blue points on the first principal component. So you can see that it has covered maximum variance in the data, and that variance is even more than the original features x1 and x2. So that's it from principal component analysis. So we'll be using principal component analysis for unsupervised way of dimensional reduction or the feature reduction. We'll study more technical details about principal component analysis in the later weeks of machine learning techniques course.